Periite sent me here. To this Dwemer ruin to go kill some... What was the guy's name? Ichindo or something like that? Who I always thought was afflicted himself, but no, he's just a regular dude.
Scholars in Cyrodiil who have dedicated their lives to solving the mystery.
He was shepherding the afflicted around this area, and for some reason. He found a new hobby or something? I don't know. Periite was upset with him about something. Even though he was doing his job. I'm not a fan of these kinds of mazes. These are more like rat mazes. Like, why is it built this way? Why did the Dwemer make a maze out of their living habitat? But it is kind of interesting how stuff's laid out. If you just keep walking, you'll eventually explore the whole area from different vantage points. There's a lot of opportunities to snipe and do camp. And what else? What else is there from Half-Life that you can do in this maze? You can do a lot of sneaking around. There's booby traps. Whoa. I was curious if they could kill these things with swords. I guess they can. I guess you, with any weapon against any enemy, eventually the two shall meet. You can kill a dragon with a fly swatter if you hit it enough times, probably. That's the problem with D&D, is it lets you use pretty much any weapon against anything. Because all weapons do is add to your damage. Your natural born instinct damage. So if your character can by their lonesome, do a damage of 8 with their fists. Imagine what they could do if they had a hammer in their fist, that kind of thing. And then, D&D also does a thing where how fast you can swing will determine how hard you can hit. So if you're swinging an axe, that even adds more to your axing ability. And it's all plus, 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 plus. The only time you get a minus is if, elf needs food badly. That's when you get a minus. Or if you're wearing a cursed armor that you cannot remove, that's a minus. You might be penalized by being slowed down. Maybe you can't lift a feather while you're wearing that armor. Stuff like that. Maybe it's disease-ridden. There's rats crawling around inside the armor, eating at your face. That's a minus. Some people love that. I try to ignore it. I try not to think about the pluses going on in these kind of games. That's a +2 sword. Oh my goodness. Driscoll's got a plus 3 sword. He's gonna win the game, you know, that kind of thing. But what bugs me even worse than the pluses is the armor class. I hate that. I hate that about old school 70s first gen role-playing games. You know, Traveler suffered from that as well. I just don't like it. But that's how the games were back then. The more armor that somebody wears in the game, the harder it is to hit them. So you're thinking, what does that mean? You mean if I shoot a bazooka at the guy in the powered suit, I can't hit him? Correct. Sounds retarded. But then you realize the nomenclature being used. Hitting does not mean the English word hit. It's a different adverb or adjective or pronoun, or I don't know, hit doesn't mean hit. Oh no, it's that dog again. That dog hates me. I'm gonna put him in the cornfield. So, the only way to hit somebody, the only way you could hit somebody is if you had a super, 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 super powerful weapon. Because obviously you are hitting the guy. When you swing a sword at a guy in an armored suit, you're obviously hitting the guy. You know, your sword makes contact with his suit. But are you really hitting the guy, though? That's the thing. If you're playing D&D, you didn't hit the guy at all. Not even a scratch. So then you have to come up with this lame-ass...
What can I do for you?
Explanation for why you're not hitting the guy with his sword.
Be sure to put it to good use.
And if you are able to hit the guy with the sword, then it's explained as, well, you find like this little extreme tiny slit opening gap in the suit of armor, and you're able to reach your sword in there and tap the guy's skin.
Bleed on, then.
Cause him to bleed a little. That's how they explain it in D&D. And people go with it because D&D, you know, D&D is for players that are addicted to the 20-sided die. That's the only reason why people even play D&D, is because of 20-sided dice. They're cool. And it's got that critical 20 roll you can do, that natural 20. Makes the whole nonsense of the rules worth it, worth all of it. Because you win the game if you roll a 20. So I'm glad, in a way, that Skyrim kind of uses percentile dice instead of a d20. Kind of, sort of.
I'm gonna cleave you with a sword. Don't you even try that.
In a zero to hero game, I think a percentile roll is a better way to go. And I like that Skyrim uses armor as a sponge to soak damage, so some damage,
what can I do for you? What do you need to take?
Can get through your suit and still get
together
you.
Together we will vanquish any foe.
You know, the more armor you're wearing, the less damage you're getting. Most second gen games do it that way.
I'm gonna leave you with a sword.
RuneQuest was one of the first second-gen games out there, I think. But by then it was too late.
Do your work.
Come on, show me how brave you are.
You know, D&D had won the popularity contest because it had already been out first. You know, D&D did everything first. It didn't do it well, it just did it first. That's all that matters. Like the Model T, it was first. Some people would argue the Model A was first. The Model A would be like chainmail. You know how you always get those fat neck beard nerds saying, "Oh, chainmail. I was playing chainmail before there was any D&D." They're talking about Model A cars. People go on eBay trying to buy chainmail. Someone's wrinkled up, smelly ass, cigarette stinking copy of the rules. And it's like there's not much rules there. Same with the Metamorphosis Odyssey. Is that what it's called? Or Metamorphosis? No, just Metamorphosis, I think is what it's called. 16 pages of garbage. It's you on a generation ship waking up from your slumber, or maybe not. Maybe you've always been awake on the generation ship, but it's a huge ship, it's giant.
Did you hear that noise? Must have been spied.
And over the years, people have mutated on board the ship into other life forms, and you're now exploring yours. Yeah, I guess you're exploring the ship. And you're fighting all the mutations on board the ship, trying to figure out what's going on, and because you know you don't even know you're on a spaceship kind of deal. That's how big the spaceship is. If I remember right,
stop it.
Anyway, some would call that a trope these days. If you like, I don't like using the word trope. Oh, there's that dog again. That's old man Wilson's dog.
What can I do for you?
Better watch out.
If that is what you wish.
Ruins can be very dangerous.
Yeah, old man Wilson has that dog. It hates me. That's why I set him on fire. So, there was a TV show called The Star Lost, which was pretty darn good. Until it jumped the shark. The first three episodes are good. After that, the writer Ben Bova, he wanted his name off the credits. He didn't want his reputation tarnished. Because they were doing stupid stuff with his creation. It became a... I want to say it became a game of crossbow after a point. Every week, Dave Bowman would find another section of the ship and he would make friends with the people that were trying to kill him. Every week, a different section of the ship was trying to kill him. I don't remember if he had a girlfriend on the show or what. You know, Cherry 2000, whatever her name was. And they would have to befriend the enemy so they can get to the rest of the ship. But first they'd have to solve the enemy's problems or help them evolve into humanity. from their mutated state, you know, whatever. Some stupid thing. It's like, oh my god, it's like the A-Team. It's, you got this A-Team and you waste your time saving nuns and orphans just to have the TV rating of G? And it just got stupid. And of course the show ends up being crap. But the first three episodes weren't too bad. Anyway, that's Metamorphosis. If I'm saying right, I should probably check. What is Wiki? The culmination of all human knowledge on the web say about the game. Okay. It's called Metamorphosis. Hang on. I'm getting shot in the face with steam here.
Good. I wish I could use a sword that well.
It's called Metamorphosis Alpha. And yeah, the game sucked. Worst. If a game could be worse than D&D, it was that one.
Yes?
Of but course. It was its own genre, I suppose. You had to have a totally different mindset to even play the game. It was not D&D in space, which is what a lot of players were hoping for at the time. But yeah, there were a lot of games that took place on generation ships, either roleplay games or board games. Video games. They all had the similar idea where your character doesn't know they're on a spaceship.
So, what are we going
now? Like I said, it, technically, you know, the geeks out there would call it a trope. It's been done before. I mean, what does trope mean? Something about its lore that you're about to plagiarize? if you're making up stuff. Some players I know, they literally go on the trope site looking for tropes to use in their game. You know, there's a trope for that. You know, instead of app, it's trope.
You know, since you and I started to travel together, I've discovered something. I'm actually quite a good fighter. Don't you think so too? Of course.
The Dwemer who built this place was sometimes called dwarves, but history records that they were no shorter than humans.
I think they should rename tropes to mundanes. Because that's really what they are, as mundanes. Or familiars. Anyway, so while we're doing the hex crawl of this place, I noticed that some of the afflicted...
So, where are we going now?
Some of the afflicted people that we killed were naked. Or we'd find a dead afflicted... And they'd be lying on the ground naked. And I'm wondering if I found another bug in the game. Did Usleep do this? Is Usleep making half the people in this dungeon naked? Or were some of the afflicted fighting before we got here? And one of my sex lab mods was making them naked. See, I've got notifications turned off, so I don't see anything from Sex Lab saying, oh, by the way, someone's now naked in the game.
I'm not afraid of spiders. That's the best thing to do, huh?
you know, that notification that says something like, the character so-and-so, who's played by such-and-such, will be naked now for the rest of the scene. I don't get those notifications.
You are nothing, stupid, stupid milk drinker.
Man, this, I don't know why, but this hallway always gives me grief. As far as frame rates go, I don't know what's going on. Pathfinding? Some monster's trying to get to us from where they are to where we are. And it's not working out. I've got this ghost sword, which, it's a wet noodle because I have no ghost sword skills. It looks pretty. Let's take some pictures of this place. I don't have my dungeons, they're not populated, so that's why this place is pretty much empty. So in the middle of all this, I've been playtesting people's NPCs they upload to the Nexus, you know, doing beta testing for them, pointing out all the issues I find. Other people just want to collect NPCs.
I'm gonna nail him with my arrow. I'll kill you! I'm gonna take that forest to
I don't remember him doing all this teleporting stuff.
That's how it's done.
Oh, he tried to get away that last time? He died during teleport. What a way to go. Yeah, most players just want to collect NPCs when they do beta tests, but they don't really say anything. They just say, awesome job, thanks for making it. But they don't say, oh, this is wrong, this is wrong, this is wrong. That's where I come in. After 5 minutes of using an NPC, I can pretty much figure out, oh, what's going on here? Why is this happening? Why are their eyeballs set up wrong? Like, why doesn't their mouth move? Why do they have purple textures, you know, the obvious things. I pick it apart, send a message to the dude, they immediately come out with a fix. Because they want their NPC companion for Skyrim to be perfect before it ends up on hot files like some do. And then you find out the thing is dreck and it has to be fixed and cleaned up.
I'm so glad that we're traveling. Tell me, what do you want?
Yes?
Because people vote for
these
mods.
These ruins are simply amazing.
Or download a mod like crazy and
so,
it ends up on the hot files.
Where are we
going now? And it's rubbish. That happens a lot. And a lot of modders don't want that to happen with their mod. They want their mod to be world famous and have it perfect from the get-go. So they do these beta things. So I suspect a mod that I've been trying out for a couple days now is going to end up on a hot list soon. It's an NPC that starts at level 90, so she's sort of a money cheat in a way. But other than that, she's shaping up pretty decent.